Newgrange. A study in stone. 40,000 tons of stone. That's a sizable lump of Ireland. But how long is it here? Well, if you guessed 5,000 years, you wouldn't be too far out. Before Stonehenge was built in England, before the Greek civilization had settled down, before there was a pyramid in Egypt, we had a thriving old civilization here. The whole area is full of mounds, tombs, most of them. Fornox near the Nile is a very quiet little place. But look around you and you can see why Celtic forebears chose this as a place. You can see seven counties from here on a fine day. The sun is always in view from Fornox, and the sun was the important thing as far as the Celts were concerned. This tomb in the Fornox was excavated early this century, and in fact it is the widest single span tomb in Western Europe. This is a cold and empty place now, but can you imagine the activity here when work was in progress? Most of these elaborate tombs took not months but years to complete. In fact, Newgrange took as much as 40 years and gave employment to hundreds of people. I suppose our government could do worse than commission a few tombs right now. Lusk was a centre, maybe the centre, of pagan worship in Fingal for about 1,000 years before Christianity was gradually established. Like now, their priests were the link between the people and the other world. Celts called them druids. And druids were fairly bright sparks, and a promising chap could spend maybe 20 years preparing for a career in the religious life. At the end of that time, he'd know everything worth knowing about what was essentially a very gentle religion. There was a great belief in the sacredness of stones or anything ancient, like oak trees or white thorns. And a crowd of children was just the thing to keep away evil spirits, and at certain times of the year, particularly in the late spring, you couldn't walk a mile in this country without bumping into a mob of pure young children horsing around a standing stone or in a sacred grove, and the affair being conducted by a priest or two. This, of course, is to keep the favour of the sun god, Lu, and to let the sun shine on their animals and crops for the season. We can never be sure of times or dates before in prehistory, but about 2,000 years ago, when Christ was on earth, such was the fame of Lusk that Cú Chulainn, the hero, was attracted to it to claim his bride Emer. At this time, we are at the stage where legend is beginning to become history, and written records are emerging.